because you too
fits where the poo fits.
I haven't even told you his name. Mom, it's John Wade Prentice. Isn't that a lovely name?
John Wade.
Joanna Prentice, I'll be.
Surprise, motherfucker.
But, Mom, there's something else that I must tell you that John's been concerned about, very deeply concerned. He's been worrying for the past week whether you and Dad would be upset if... Well, it's about time. I was wondering where you'd been. Mom, this is John.
Dr. Prentice, I'm so pleased to meet you.
I'm pleased to meet you, Mrs. Drayton. I take it Joanna's already busted out with the big news.
Well, she has told me a good deal, and all very quickly, too.
She's only known me for 10 days, so she can't tell you when I'm blushing. That could be another problem for us, you know. Mrs. Drayton, I'm medically qualified, so I hope you wouldn't think it presumptuous if I say you ought to sit down before you fall down, I mean.
He thinks you're gonna faint because he's a Negro.
That's crazy!
Well, it's my fault. See, we have a sort of a situation here. Joanna and I didn't just meet in Hawaii. We spent a good deal of time together. I mean, all the time after we met. And, well, we have this problem. I fell in love with your daughter.
Did this ever occur to you that this might happen?
No.
Never occurred to me either. Not once. Well, can you tell me your reaction? How do you feel about it?
Oh, I don't know. No,
they may mean what they're saying. I accept that, but they don't know what they're doing. I won't accept that.
Surprise, motherfucker.
Please, come in.
I'd like to have a couple of minutes with the two of you, if I may. Mm-hmm.
Sure, Doctor. Come on in.
There's something you both ought to know. I made a decision. Joanna doesn't know about it, and I don't see any reason why she should.
What is it, Doctor?
Joanna thinks she's committed, and that our whole future is settled, but there is no real commitment. And up to now, nothing is settled at all.
I don't understand that. Joanna said you're going to be married no matter what we might think about it.
Well, that's not the case. Unless you two approve, and without any reservations at all, there won't be any marriage.
I remember when I was about your age, my sports editor telling me that Negroes would never be able to play baseball.
That's crazy!
Is that the way Joey feels?
She feels that every single one of our children will be president of the United States, and they'll all have colorful administrations.
Would you think it was some kind of cowardice if I told you that no matter how confident you two are, I'm just a little scared?
No. It wouldn't. But you never know.
An absolute bitch.
You say you don't want to tell me how to live my life. So what do you think you've been doing? You tell me what rights I've got or haven't got and what I owe to you for what you've done for me? Let me tell you something. I owe you nothing. If you carried that bag a million miles, you did what you were supposed to do. Because you brought me here.
From that day, you owed me everything you could ever do for me, like I will owe my son if I ever have another. You don't owe me.
How about your glasses? Can I get you a drink, either Mr. and Mrs. Prentice?
No, thank you.
John? Mike? No, you've had enough as it is already.
Dad? What's going on?
Get back in the kitchen!
This has been a very strange day. I don't think that's putting it too strongly. I might even say it's been an extraordinary day. I need to make a few personal statements. For a variety of reasons.
When I was a little kid, I used to have crazy dreams because, do you remember that, you remember Nestle's Quick? You know, the powder, you'd put it in your milk, and you'd stir it for like 30...
Oh my God, who the hell can...
Joey? Shut up.